Today we are going to see chapter number 1, that is introduction of partnership of standard 12 commerce subject account. So this is the third part of the chapter number 1, and in our last video we have seen the partnership deed as well as partner meaning of partnership and characteristic of partnership. Today here we are going to see the capital account method. So here, as we discussed before, according to deed and act, we have to see how we have to prepare the capital account. So here, according to that, we can prepare a capital account of partner according to two methods. Very first method is a fluctuating capital account method, and the second one is a fixed capital account method. So today we are going to discuss about that. Let's see. Okay, now let's see partner's capital account method, where we are going to see two types of capital account. In that, very first is a fluctuating capital account method. So here, fluctuating capital account method means a method in which opening balance and closing balance of capital account of any partner is reported fluctuating, is known as fluctuating or temporary capital account method. So here, when there is an opening and closing balance of the partner's capital account is different, that method is called fluctuating capital account method. In a fluctuating capital account method, we are going to prepare only one account, and that account is called partner's capital account. And here is the specimen of the partner's capital account. So here, balance brought down or in a where the credit balance of a capital account is there, then we are going to write the same on the credit side. And then here, if any addition in a capital is there that can be brought by any partner, it can be by cash, bank, or any asset will be brought by partner, it will be reported on the credit side of partner capital account. Then interest on capital will be paid to the partner, and that is also supposed to be right on the credit side of the partner's capital account. After that, if any salary, bonus, commission, or remuneration are supposed to be paid to the partner, that is also going to be right on the credit side of the partner's capital account. And afterward, the last thing is a profit and loss of appropriation account. So if any divisible profit is there, that is going to divide on between the partner, and that is also going to be credited to partner's capital account. And on the debit side of partner's capital account, we are going to write if any debit balance, generally there will be no debit balance of the capital account, but sometime if any debit balance is there in of partner capital account, that's supposed to be debited on the debit side. The next one is a drawing of a partner. If any partner withdraw any money from the partnership firm, that is supposed to be written on the debit side of the partner's capital account. Afterward, if any interest is charged from the partner, that is also debited to the partner's capital account. And if any loss can be there in the partnership firm, that is also supposed to be debited. So here, this is how we are going to find out the closing balance of the partner capital account. So here, if any credit balance is there, that is supposed to be written on the liability side of the balance sheet. And if any debit balance can be found in the partner's capital account, that is supposed to be written on the asset side of the balance sheet. So this is how we are supposed to prepare a fluctuating capital account. Under there, we are going to prepare the capital account. Students, you may note down this. Then we are going to see the second method, that is fixed capital account, and where we are going to prepare two accounts. Very first account is a capital account, and the second account is a current account. Accounting method is a fixed capital account method, where the capital of the partners are going to be fixed. That means there is no change in the opening and closing balance of a partner's capital account. So where we are going to write the change during the year? So for that, we are going to create another account. That account is called partner's current account. the first account is a partner's capital account and the second account is a partner's current account. So here in a partner's capital account, we are going to make the changes of capital only, and the other transaction with the partners and firm we are going to record in the partner's current account. So here, definition of the fixed capital account method is a method of capital under which no change is reported. No change is reported in the opening balance and the closing balance of partner's capital account is known as fixed capital account method. So this is the definition, and here under this method to record all the transactions of partners with the firm, we are going to prepare two accounts, and that two account is called partner's capital account as well as partner's current account. And here the specimen of the partner's capital account is here. Opening balance of partner capital account will be reported on the credit side, and here whatever additional capital is going to brought by partner, that we are going to write on the credit side of the partner's capital account. And whatever withdrawal of the capital, here withdrawal means withdrawal of capital only, we are going to write on the debit side of partner's capital account. And then we are going to find out the closing balance of a partner's capital account. So this is the specimen of partner's capital account under fixed capital account method. And here the other account that we are going to prepare is called partner's current account, where we are going to write all the transaction of partner with the firm. In that, very first thing we are going to write, if the balance of the current account is a credit, then we are going to write on the credit side. But if there is a debit balance of partner capital account, then we are going to write on the debit side of a current account. Then interest on capital we are going to chart, we'll write over here. Then interest on credit balance of current account. So whatever the balance is there of a current account, on that if any interest supposed to be paid to the partner, then it's supposed to be right on the credit side. Then salary, bonus, commission, remuneration, and lastly here we are going to credit the divisible profit, that is profit and loss appropriation account. And on the debit side of the partner's current account, we are going to write drawing, then interest on drawing, then interest on debit balance of current account we are going to charge from the partner, that we are going to write over here. And the last thing is a divisible loss, that means whatever loss is there in the business, that we are going to write on the debit side of a current account. That's when we are going to find out closing balance. So here for the current account, the balance of the partner's current account can be debit or credit. So if there is a credit balance of a partner's current account, that is going to be right on the liability side of the asset. And if there is a debit balance of a partner's current account, that in the balance sheet we are going to write on the asset side. So this is how we supposed to prepare partner's capital account under two methods, that is fluctuating capital account method as well as fixed capital account method. Students, you may note down this. Thank you for watching this video. In our next video, we are going to see how to prepare the profit and loss appropriation account.